This next question is from an anonymous viewer. She says, I have been watching your videos for a couple of weeks. I have even gone back and watched some earlier videos of Lynn helping people with their pain. I would love to understand what is going on in your current videos. I can't keep track of if someone else is talking through you, Lynn, or if it is your words.
These are not our words. The Angelic Initiative is a series of channeled videos. These are the words of angels and godly presences associated with planet Earth who are all working together to try to awaken humanity. We attempt to adjust our opinions and learn from the words that come through us. We're working this footage afterward, we watch it and sometimes we pause it and say, wow, well, I need to think about this.
That's
I need
true.
To work through this. I really, this is not what I have been thinking. And so far, they're right. They're just right.
That's
and
true.
Every single time, they're right and we're wrong. Every single time. And after 29 years of this, there's no longer any confusion over here. When our thinking doesn't match their thinking, we already know how it's going to turn out.
That's
it's
true.
It's going to turn out that we were wrong and they were right. And
that's
so we
right.
can just check our attitude and go with their words. Now, we understand that somebody who's 2 weeks into the process is not going to be at the same place as somebody who's 29 years into the process.
That's
and
true.
But that's okay. It is okay. So these are the words of the angels and godly presences. This is what the angels are saying. And godly presences.
That's true.
It is their words. Does that answer the question?
Oh, the next question is from a viewer named Justin. And Justin asks, it would be interesting to hear your opinion on transgender and gender fluid people in a video.
Thank you, Justin. We see a lot of those divine presences looking at each other, and they look uncomfortable, like they don't want to talk about this.
Yes. Like some of them think they'd like to take a bathroom break.
They feel like they'd like to take a bathroom break, so we're really asking that those doors be locked, because
that's
if you
true.
Guys aren't going to answer this question, then shame on you. Because this is a reality that's playing out on planet Earth. And now somebody is coming forward.
I see that
presence.
Let me
see if I can figure out who it is. It's a really high-ranking soul. I can tell that.
Yeah, that's true.
Very high-ranking. And possibly a soul who doesn't speak much, but somebody to whom we should all listen.
That's what it feels like.
And this presence is talking about soul change.
Yes.
And this is a topic that is not, unfortunately, widely discussed, because it is carrying out on a large scale on planet Earth right now.
That's true.
And now they're starting to talk amongst each other about what's causing it.
Yeah, that's
and
true.
They're talking about the oppositional defiant disorder that seems to be rampant among not only humans, but they're talking about humans right now.
That's true.
Because this video is more likely to be seen by humans than by oak trees, for example.
That's true.
And so they're attempting to answer the questions of humanity. And they're saying that when humans get this, I don't want to do it and you can't make me, attitude toward the souls, that sometimes the souls will try and try and try and try and then say, you know what, I've got better things to do with my time. I'll just hang out over here, and when you're ready to stop being a jerk, then let me know and we'll try again.
That's true.
And then the soul is gone, and the soul gets involved in whatever it is the soul has gone to do.
That's true.
And now the life is one of those kind of zombie lives that
yes.
after a while you can recognize them. It's the way the eyes look, and it's a little creepy. But they're everywhere. They're
That's
everywhere.
True.
And then there are also these clouds of dead people who are not wanting to go to God because they think they've been bad and they don't want to have the talk and they don't want to have the consequences of their actions. And law of attraction is real. And so these lives who don't want to do what they were born to do with that revolting, angry pushback are attracting souls who are also kind of revolting and angry.
Yes, that's
and
true.
And it's a lose-lose-lose situation. It's a cycle of bad. Everybody loses. The reality is that bodies and souls are supposed to be a melded, committed team.
That's true.
Think of it like a marriage.
Yes.
And this is supposed to be for life between the soul and the body.
That's true.
And there are things that the souls are doing, like pulling out of the life right before a painful event, and that's bad.
That's true.
And there are things that the lives are doing, basically saying, I don't want to do what I was born to do. And you
stay away,
can't make
soul.
Me stay away, sorry. Stinky soul, all those things that are also bad. So it's problematic on multiple levels and from multiple angles.
That's true.
But the reality of soul change is real. And when you have, for example, a male body whose male soul blows out of it because the male body is in lockdown defiance.
That's true.
And then a female soul kind of is pulled into the life by law of attraction.
That's true.
She starts to feel like a woman trapped in a man's body, and
that's
now she
true.
Wants to cut off the penis.
Yeah.
And make it a more hospitable environment for herself.
That's true.
And similarly, if the female soul blows out of the female body, and now it's an empty female life, and then a male soul is just kind of sucked in through law of attraction.
That's true.
Starts to feel like a man trapped in a woman's body.
That's true.
And again, they're jumping right for the Western medical solutions. And it may or may not be the correct choice, the best option given the state of affairs, because once that original soul blows out, it may not be coming back.
That's true.
It may be coming back, but it may not
it
be coming back. Every person's unique. Every situation is unique.
That's
never
true.
Say never. And the question is, what are the best options available to that life at that point in time? Does this answer the question?
The next question is from a viewer named Michael. And Michael says, hi Lynn, what's your opinion on LGBT people?
Hi Michael, we're not going to give you our opinion. We don't think our opinion is of value to anybody.
That's true.
We speak what they're saying. The angels are saying this and there's like a chorus of them. It's
like
they're singing
like a choir.
In harmony.
That's true.
And they're saying that the T answer has already been given very well.
That's true.
The transgenderism. And so they want to kind of set that aside and talk about the LGB
That's
portion
true.
Of it. And again, they're detangling it and saying we can call L and G just G because it's the same.
That's true. That's what
it's
they're saying.
Just a gender verbatim. Bias. And B is something different.
That's true.
So they're saying the gay population, the homosexual population, consists of lives whose original souls made the choice to be born gay.
Oh yeah, that feels true.
It's not easy to be gay. It's much harder to be gay than straight.
That's true.
So often those are advanced souls. Almost never are they beginner souls.
That's
the beginner
true.
Souls choose the easy lives.
Oh yeah.
These are advanced souls who have, for whatever reason, chosen to be gay. And then from there can be many different reasons that the soul chose to be gay.
That's
but
true.
The point is that it's a pre-birth choice to be gay. It's part of the soul plan to be gay. And so the rest of humanity can back off a little bit and give those people the right to be who their souls want them to be.
That's true.
Just back off. Leave them alone. And obviously they make their own choices, and we're not saying that gay culture is perfect, because
no, that's true.
It's imperfect also, but it's pre-birth choice. Leave them alone. Let them get married if that's what they want. And none of us should be having children.
That's
no
true.
More children. We have too many children. We have too many adults. We have too many humans.
That's true.
So now we want to talk about the B, bisexual.
That's what that presence is saying.
That's what that presence is saying.
Room.
And they're saying sometimes people really are wanting to accomplish good things, and they're really wanting a life partner to work with them in the effort. And they've got so many requirements on their list of ideal mate that they have a hard time finding somebody if they're also being picky about gender.
That's true.
And so sometimes those presences are just saying, all right, it doesn't matter to me if it's a man or a woman. It matters more to me that this person shares my interest in the environment or the arts or whatever it is. So that's one set of reasons for bisexuality, of just having a lot of important goals and being willing to bend on gender. But soul change is another real reason for bisexuality.
That's
and
true.
Sometimes we have lives that are just kind of like wind tunnels that souls are blowing through.
That's
and sometimes
true.
It's a male soul in the life, and sometimes it's a female soul in the life. And so bisexuality happens.
That's true.
This issue of soul body disconnect is a serious problem of our times. Sorry if this is inconvenient information. Does it answer the question?
This next question is from a viewer named Shannon, and Shannon says, I'm pretty new to your videos. Are you speaking for yourselves, or are you channeling higher beings?
We're channeling higher beings. These are angelic channels. We hope that that's clear. That having been said, we listen to what they say.
That's
These
true.
Host lives consider, at least this host life considers herself a student of the angels and higher presences.
A really serious student.
A very serious student. When we intend to learn and adjust our thinking to match what they say.
That's true.
So these statements become our opinions over time.
That's
we may
true.
Not agree with them when they're said,
That's
but
true.
We really work to come into agreement with them and to change our lives to match them. We attempt to live by these teachings.
That's true.
Does that answer the question?
This question is actually from this life. How do we get the souls to stop abandoning their assigned lives?
How do we get the souls to stop abandoning their assigned lives? The assigned lives have got to understand that there's a certain level of toxicity that the souls cannot survive.
That's true.
This is that same voice who spoke once before.
That's true.
Maybe on the transgender
That's
question.
That's who it sounds like.
It's that same voice. And this is an extremely high-ranking soul.
That's true.
Somebody to whom we should all be listening. That high-ranking soul is saying, you've got to understand that when the environment is toxic to a soul, the soul has the choice of leaving or dying.
That's true.
And a dead soul does nobody any good.
That's
and
true.
And so the souls do have to get out of there to survive. Think of it like poison gas. The soul can come in and operate a little bit, but then they need to go up and get a new tank of air.
That's true.
And to detox, we have seen it build up in good quality souls and see them not be able to survive anymore.
Oh yeah.
We have seen it happen over and over again. So really the lives need to stop being toxic. So stop taking drugs, live clean. These lives, this is a frequently asked question. What drugs are you on? We don't take any drugs.
No.
These lives take no drugs, nor have they for many, 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 many years. We don't drink alcohol.
No.
We don't smoke. We don't take antihistamines. We don't take antibiotics.
No.
We're living as clean can be. We drink water. That's what we drink. We eat primarily vegan. We do have a flock of chickens and we eat their eggs.
That's true.
We live as clean and clean as we can be. So live a clean life. Try to be a place where a decent quality soul can survive. Stay away from lies. Stay away from liars. Just stay away from it. Don't participate in it. It's toxic. Lies are toxic to the soul. Take responsibility. Don't be a life your soul wants to abandon.
That's true.
Don't be selfish. Don't be an ingrate. Don't be lazy. Work hard. Be in service. Think of others. Think of others who are extremely different than you are. Speak up for the dispossessed. Tithe. Don't be stingy. Be a place a decent quality soul can survive. Does this answer your question? How many are left?
Five. Five questions left.
Five questions left. I don't have it in me to do a good job channeling five more answers.
No, that's true.
Okay, friends, we're going to have to take a break on this because this takes a lot of effort, energy, focus to do this. And after a while, if I don't take a break, then I'm just giving you some dead person's opinion, and I have zero interest in that.
That's true.
So we're going to have to take a break, and we thank you for your patience.